Hello, and welcome to Chemistry in Your Cupboard. I'm Catherine, and I'm an Education Coordinator for the Royal Society of Chemistry. Today, I'm going to try some spacecraft survival. I'm going to investigate how to get clean water from contaminated water. For example, if astronauts need to purify their water to survive in space, you can try this at home with a responsible adult. Let's get started. For this experiment, we're going to need one big container and a small one that fits inside. If you're using something lightweight, you'll also need some Blu-tac to hold it in place. Some water, just cold tap water is fine, and a teaspoon. Something to make the water dirty. We'll call this our contaminant as it contaminates the water. I'm going to use some salt and some blue food colouring, but you could also use powder paint. Some cling film and something to weigh the cling film down. This could be a ball of Blu-tac, a stone, or I've got a little pot. And some time, as this is an experiment we can observe over about a week. First, I'm going to make my contaminated water by mixing some tap water with some blue food colouring and some salt. And give that a good mix until it's all dissolved. Now let's set up the containers. So put the smaller one in the middle of the larger one. Mine's already quite heavy, but if you're using something made of plastic, you'll need to stick it to the bottom with some Blu-tac. Then I can pour my water into the larger container, making sure it doesn't spill into the smaller container in the middle. The more water you use, the longer the experiment will take. Then cover the whole thing with cling film. Doesn't need to be stretched too tight, but as long as it covers all the edges. And then finally, pop a weight on the top. The water will evaporate and then collect under the cling film, and then run down until it gets to the weight in the middle and drop into the smaller container. So make sure everything is lined up properly. Next, we wait. Pop the experiment in a sunny place, maybe a windowsill, and see what happens over time. So we left the experiment running for about a week, and while it was running you could see condensation on the inside of the container and little droplets of liquid on the cling film running down into the middle. I've let it cool down so there's no more liquid on the cling film, so let's see what's happened. So I can see that most of the liquid that was in the outer container has evaporated and it's left behind little blue crystals. So that must be the salt that I dissolved in the water with the blue food colouring. In the bowl in the middle, I've got some clear liquid. But let's have a look properly. Wow, that looks pretty clear to me. It doesn't smell of anything. And it tastes like pure water too. But if you've used non-food contaminants, don't try the liquid afterwards. So what we've done is we've cleaned our water using the water cycle. So in our mixture, the water with the heat from the sun evaporated and then it condensed. In the water cycle, it does this in the clouds, but in our experiment, this was on the cling film. And then it precipitates or rains back down to Earth. And in our experiment, this was the water dropping from the cling film into the container in the middle. So that was spacecraft survival. If astronauts in space needed to purify their water, this might be one way they'd do it. I wonder what other contaminants you could remove using this method. Could you separate squash from water? Have a go and let us know how you get on using the hashtag #ChemistryInYourCupboard. We'll be back with more experiments soon. In the meantime, make sure your grown-up subscribes to the YouTube channel for all the latest Chemistry in Your Cupboard videos. See you soon.